evening. My name is Kevin. Welcome to New Familiar Faces. Today, Father, Chris celebrates Mass with us. Something to think about today and during the week. Always remember that one kind word can change someone's entire day. Please stand as we sing together.
Thanks for your great glory. hearts, we pray, with the warmth of your love, so that loving you in all things and above all things, we may attain your promises, which surpass every human desire. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, for ever and ever.
Amen.
First reading from the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, have a care for justice, act with integrity, for soon my salvation will come and my integrity be manifest. Foreigners who have attached themselves to the Lord to serve him and to love his name and to be his servants, all who observe the Sabbath, not profaning it and cling to my covenant, these I will bring to my holy mountain. I will make them joyful in my house of prayer. Their holocausts and their sacrifices will be accepted on my altar, for my house will be called a house of prayer for all the peoples. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
Jesus left Gennesaret and withdrew to the region of Tyre and Sidon. Then out came a Canaanite woman from that district and started shouting, "Sir, son of David, have pity on me. My daughter is tormented by a devil." But he answered her not a word. And his disciples went and pleaded with him, "Give her what she wants, because she is shouting after us." He said in reply, "I was sent only to the lost sheep of the house of Israel." But the woman had come up and was now kneeling at his feet. "Lord," she said, "help me." He replied, "It is not fair to take the children's food and throw it to the house dogs." She retorted, "Ah, yes, sir, but even house dogs can eat the scraps that fall from the master's table." Then Jesus answered her, "Woman, you have great faith. Let your wish be granted." And from that moment, her daughter was well again. The Gospel of the Lord.
And
fobs are off, which is difficult for us to read sometimes. And even the disciples said, just give her what I want, what she wants, and then we can get rid of her, and then we can continue having a quiet time up here, a time of rest. But she then gets up to him, falls to her knees in front of him, and says again, have pity on me, have pity on my daughter. He has that wonderful conversation where he says, I'm here to feed those of my own faith, the Jews, and not anyone else. And what's that lovely phrase? He says, it is not fair to take the children's food, the love of Jesus and everything he was doing, and throw it to the house dogs, the pagans. But the Canaanite woman said, but I have the ability to eat even the crumbs that fall from the table. Just give me something, Lord, I still believe in you. It's a very powerful conversation that they are having. And Jesus answered her by saying, woman, you have great faith. He knows. It was a test for her, and it's a test of us for our faith as well. When we are calling out to God to help someone in our family who is ill, who is sick, who requires their help, because we feel it sometimes as much as they do. And this is the great gospel we come back to. She is the only woman in the gospel to outwit Jesus with her retort. And she is the woman of faith. Even though she wasn't of his faith, she was a woman of faith that brought many people to faith, and today brings many people to faith. And I'm sure St. Paul, when he was walking his roads, that he would have heard of this story. Remember, Paul came after the death of Jesus. So he would have heard this story and how that would have changed his way of thinking about who do we go out to share our faith. Do we just keep it to ourselves? Is it exclusive or is it inclusive for everyone? So it's that gospel we hook into when we are perhaps losing our faith somewhat in trusting what God can do for us. We need to be like this woman, the woman from Canaan.
We pray for our Pope,
priests, and all the faithful, that they may persevere with steadfast faith and to be united in the Holy Spirit through the Gospel and the Eucharist. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the world leaders and all whose decisions affect the lives of others, that wisdom will always be their guide and humility their compass. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the elderly and frail, that they may know the closeness of the Lord and the love of this community. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who gather around the table of the Lord today, that their faith may be strong and their trust complete. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died, that they may rest in peace and rise in glory. We remember especially Maureen Groves and Alan Farr. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Loving Father, you watch over each one of us in our troubles. Help us to be attentive to your will, to trust you, and to stay close to you through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts.
Father, in the name
away from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign for ever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. We share with one another the peace of the Lord.
My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Including more music. We've got Baruch coming up shortly, and Father Nixon and I are away on Tuesday and Wednesday. We have a meeting in Christchurch to attend, so there will be no mass on those 2 days. Thank you for being here. What a difference 12 hours makes, isn't it? We were all in the garden yesterday, 16 degrees, cool, someone was here, and at 12 o'clock today it's still 4. Awful, wasn't it? Let's stand and pray. Made partakers of Christ through these sacraments, we humbly implore your mercy, Lord, that conformed to his image on earth, we may merit also to be his co-heirs in heaven, who lives and reigns with you forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in the peace of the Lord.
Praise be to God.